Hi, welcome to the National Quiz Choice Online News, and here at Franchise Licensing Asia 2013. Tell us more about TermiCam.
TermiCam is a thermal imaging inspection method using high-end thermal imaging cameras. The capability of a thermal camera is endless. We specialize in the pest industry finding termites that no one else had ever done. We started back in 89 and discovered a way to find termites using cameras, especially in Australian power poles, where they were falling down and they couldn't work out what the problem was until we found a way of doing it. And then from there we looked at it and thought, well, building structures are made of timber. It's got to work in buildings. So we started the process and launched the product in 2000, and our first franchise came out of Singapore. But it's a high-end technology. It's not rocket science, but you've got to have common sense about how energy comes out, how you translate that energy, and then looking at patterns on the camera, dissecting the images, what they look like, and then you put your thinking cap back on and you look at the image and you go, yes, that's an infestation, or it's something else. It could be a plumbing issue, it could be an electrical issue, or it could be something leaking in behind the wall. So you're virtually like a detective, but with a very sophisticated device.
And how many years of experience does TermiCam has?
15 years. We've been going 15 years.
Wow. Now, what's next for TermiCam? Are you doing any research?
The next research stage for us is bed bugs. And there's cockroaches, of course, but the one that most people are after is bed bugs. It's a national problem and a worldwide problem. We have a couple of images of the bed bug, but we've still got a bit more research to do. And we're finding different patterns in different countries, so it's not a simple pattern that's unique. Each country has their own type of pattern. The same as termites, it's a different signature again in every country, and there's different species. So you've got to start thinking about the process, what to do, how to do it, and then come up with the outcome. But it's all to do with training, which we specialise in with our franchise model that we have.
Now, for our viewers, they have a question for you, and that is, what about qualification? Does it take someone with a degree or some sort of qualification to engage a franchise?
That's a good question. Thermal imaging is fairly new in Australia and New Zealand. It's been around about 20 years now. In the last 10 years, they've brought in certification to ISO. But we're finding in Australia, especially, that the ISO program doesn't meet the criteria of Australian standards, which has the overriding factor. So a group of us has got together and formed an association that now is writing standards for Australian standards, particularly for pest industry, electrical, building, and so forth. Training takes about 40 hours. That's a theory and a practical examination. Entry to these is probably year four science, maths. It's not really a prerequisite, but it does help you. And the course takes 5 days. After that, you do your tests. If you pass your test, then you can come out as a certified thermographer in level one, level two, and level three.
And so how can our viewers get more information? Do you have a website?
Okay, for the thermal imaging side of the website, you can go to atandt.com.au, which is an Australian website, and that's where you can find information about thermography. If you want to get into a franchise into TermiCam, it is termicam.com, and that'll get you all the information you require.
Now, does the organization require any form of experience or qualification for anyone who wants to take up a franchise?
No, trade background would be good, but it's not necessarily. I mean, if we're looking for a master franchise, we can have an investor who can then employ the right people to do the work that they need to do. But if you have a trade background and you want to start off a fresh new trade, yeah, or hands-on sort of person and can think outside the square, it's an easy tool to work with once you get trained properly.
Now, what kind of criteria are you looking for in a franchisee?
A person who can run a business. Marketing skills is very important. I mean, anybody anybody can run a business, but if you haven't got marketing skills, you just don't go anywhere. You can be a simple little operator, but if you have a real smart brain about marketing the product, getting it out there, you can do almost anything and become something that no one else has done before.
And what kind of investment are they looking at?
A single franchise operation is $50,000 US, up to $1.5 million for a master franchise. And that master franchise depends on the size of the country. Like, you wouldn't give a one master franchise for $2 million in the United States. There'd be multiples of those. But say like Singapore, this was a master franchise. He's now got 6 cameras operating. He's got 8 technicians, specially trained. He's doing quite well. It's a very good operation here in Singapore. So much so we then branched out into Brunei, where we've got an international office. We're looking at a second camera going into there. And then from there, we hope to branch out everywhere. But one franchise, one little territory, $50,000 US. And then, of course, you've got your royalty stream, like most franchises. So it's a pretty simple process. And in that, you get all your training, you get your camera, you get all the business structure. So you can basically come in without any qualifications whatsoever. We can get you up to speed within a few weeks. By the time we get started, it'll be 8 weeks of training all up, and you come out with all the relevant information that you need.
Well, once again, that was Mr. David Rice. Thank you for joining us here at National Business Choice. And until then, we'll see you next year.
Thank you very much.